Hey, everybody, it's the coach. Welcome to the special Saturday edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got a great one on tap between the Seattle Seahawks and the New Orleans Saints. With that, let's get over to the Mercedes-Benz Superdome with the call from New Orleans. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
First opened back in 1975, there's a look inside the iconic Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. The setting in this dome just serves to amplify the excitement of the folks in New Orleans as their Saints burst from the tunnel a moment ago. They're set, and we're set as well as the Saints get ready to do battle with Russell Wilson and the Seattle Seahawks. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Kicker for the Saints, Will Lutz, has it teed up, and here we go from New Orleans. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. So out come the Seahawks now for their first possession. They'll be led out by their 5'11 quarterback from Wisconsin by way of NC State, and that's Russell Wilson.
He's always been an incredible decision maker on the field. Takes care of the ball really well, puts his team in the right positions, makes sure the play calls are accurate. Also was a minor league baseball player. Didn't hit very well there. I think he made a great career choice picking football.
Here's Wilson. That's complete to DK Metcalf. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
Now the former Notre Damer, this is CJ Procise. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll bring up a 2nd and 11. That play never got off the ground.
And a lot of times defenses want to disguise their intentions. Not in this case. They came full bore after him and really whacked him on that play. A big time loss.
Let's go, T. It's going to be a long day.
Draw play. This is Carson. He gets them a little over half of what they needed. Now they're looking at a 3rd and 5.
It's a gain of 6. And it's 3rd down.
Quick, move it in. Mike 47. Or twist.
From the gun on 3rd down, Wilson flushed out right. He may try and run for this. Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to 4th down.
You know, I don't think this is the last time we'll see that in this game. This guy has mobility, and they want to use his legs in the game plan. So there will be designed runs as well as his scrambles.
On 4th down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. Deontay Harris deep for New Orleans. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And this one's out of bounds. Should be inside the 10, I think it is. At the 6-yard line. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complementary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
Big stop, G. Big stop. Let's go.
Able to slither by. This one into the hands of Ginn out wide. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Brings up second and three at the 13-yard line.
Ready. We're waiting. Check, check. Walk 54. Walk 54. And I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you. Right.
They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 15.
He was taken down by KJ Wright. It's a gain of a yard. Brings up third down and two.
Ready. Yellow weighty, yellow weighty. 54. Check, 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 check.
Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And he'll be taken down, losing yardage back at the 9-yard line. They went backwards 5 yards there on third down to bring up fourth.
Have to admit to a little bit of surprise on that play call. Short yardage and they tried to go wide. They got spilled for their efforts.
Here's Thomas Morstead now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. Good open field tackling there, a 50-yard punt followed by just a 1 yard return. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trade expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a second and 3, second and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. Don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Here's Wilson. Gonna throw again. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. The dump off gets them 9, so now they're in much better shape for third down. Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get 9 yards out of it, leaving him with his third and one. They'll toss it out to Carson. And shedding the tackle, and now some room. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. It was third and short, and they go flying past the marker for a gain of nearly 30 yards. Relatively small sample size, but that's his longest run of the first quarter. Bounced it out to the outside to make it successful.
And to get there, you actually need some help. It's not just your pure speed getting to the corner, making sure that the blocking is taken care of inside so the pursuit doesn't get you. And oftentimes, those wide receivers, tight ends that might be flexed out, they've got to control the edge and make sure no one from the outside can spill the play before he gets there.
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 25-yard line. Now Wilson, and he's going to lose a yard or two, taken down behind the line. Cameron Jordan able to collapse the pocket, get to him, and drop him for a loss of a yard. The sack cost him only a yard. It's second and 11. Now Wilson. That's into the hands of his tight end, Will Dissly. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Wilson. Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And there is absolutely zero pressure on the quarterback on that play. Third down, and he has all the time in the world to eventually find an open receiver for a first down pickup.
Wilson after the play fake to Carson. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. And now a look at the Saints starting defense.
When you're drafted 12th overall, people expect big things out of you, and Sheldon Rankins can provide that. Big, strong, physical player, has excellent quickness, and is really good with his hands, keeping blockers off of him and allowing him to get upfield and into opposing backfields.
They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. Now a give, right side. It's Carson. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It's a pickup of 3, but still a little work to do on third and goal.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
Wilson. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sacked back around the 8. Marcus Davenport, the first rounder out of UTSA with a sack. On comes the Seahawk kicker here on fourth down. It's Jason Myers. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. Myers' kick is good. And the Seahawks grab a 3-0 lead. So good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coaches always talk about finishing a drive with a kick. 2 of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
Myers now converted on the field goal try. Now he's on to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. They'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. Let's go. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Ready? You ready?
You rush.
Looking to throw on second down. Breeze. The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up third and 10. Shotgun now for Breeze. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Well done on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at the 40. They go play action with Wilson. Rolling to his right. And he's going to keep it here. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. On 2nd down. It's Carson, and he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. 10 yards and a Seattle first down. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and are controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. This is Carson. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
We are watching a runner having a really nice game. Carrying it very well. Vision is excellent, but boy, look at the help he's getting. Offensive line, I think they're pretty eager to block for him.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's 2nd and a yard. Now it's Carson. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up 3rd down. Good opening quarter for him. Remember, he had the sack earlier. Now a tackle for loss, another tackle for loss.
He's really making it tough on the play caller, though, isn't he? Because it's one thing to try and adjust when a guy is disrupting your running game. But when he's messing up your passing game as well, they may have to devote at least a second guy to him to try and keep him away from their plays.
On 3rd down, Carson. He's got a 1st down and much more inside the 20. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Chris Carson. 32 yards. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. So they went to the ground game on 3rd, hoping to pick up the 1st. They also picked up a touchdown.
Offensive linemen so used in this situation to having a pass block. All right, you're looking at what it is, 3rd down. They don't care that it's 3rd and whatever. They figure they're going to throw the ball. And when you call a running play, I think you energize them. I think you juice them up, because I haven't met offensive linemen yet that likes to pass block more than they like to run block. And they opened up some nice holes there for him, and he took it to the house.
Myers connects on the PAT, and the lead grows to 10-0. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. And it was all capped off by the Chris Carson touchdown run. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This will be taken in at the one. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to his running back, Alvin Kamara, and that'll bring up second down. Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Now Breeze. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
Brings up a third down and 10 yards to go.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions.
We gotta step it up.
Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Open man is Michael Thomas. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain of 22.
Press coverage on the outside, and for defenders, that's the ultimate risk-reward. If you take the risk, can you reward yourself by keeping them on the line of scrimmage? But no, not on that one. Got the step on him. Now it's just a matter of laying the ball out there for him to go get it.
First down is Breeze. Again has it complete. And he'll get it down here to the 43.
Ready.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Again, they'll throw with Breeze. This is caught by Gann. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A gain there of 21 yards. First down carry, it's Kamara. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. Making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner. The first down run got five, here's second and five.
Here we go, D, get off the field.
Now Breeze. That is caught at the 7. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Breeze to another longtime vet, Ginn, for the New Orleans first.
First and goal at the 8-yard line.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. From the gun, it's Breeze. And that will be caught, but out of the end zone, says the field judge. It's ruled incomplete.
You got to be precise with your throws, especially in this situation. You're inside the 10-yard line going into the end zone. But sometimes the emotion, the excitement, sometimes the decisions just aren't made very well because of that.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. Now a first carry for Latavius Murray. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to 3rd and goal. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on 3rd and goal? There's Breeze. And it's caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. A 7-yard touchdown grab as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter.
A good tight end is a heck of a weapon for any quarterback, especially when you're able to create some mismatches. Sometimes they work against a linebacker, sometimes they work against a smaller defensive back. But when they find it, they go to it, and it often results in touchdowns.
Will Lutz on for the point after. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. A 10-play drive that time. And it all culminates in a Saints touchdown. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This fielded at the 2. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line.
There's so many times during camp and practice that you get bored as a player doing regular drills. But how about that shed and skate drill right there by the linebacker? You do it each and every day. Get the blocker away and get into the backfield and make a big-time tackle. That's what we just saw.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. Here's Carson. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. 10-7 our score after 1 right here on EA Sports. The Seahawks on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Now it's Wilson. This one into the hands of Metcalf. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Here's Wilson to throw. The catch is made here by Tyler Lockett. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision, and receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. They run it with Carson. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7. From the 35 on second down, Wilson. That's complete to Disley, the tight end. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 21. It's Carson, and he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just 1. DeMario Davis there on the stop.
A gain of a yard brings up 2nd and 9 at the Saints 20-yard line.
Check 380.
Check Mike 54. Mike 54. Hey, what?
On 2nd and 9, Wilson, he'll find Metcalf. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
A 3-yard gain on the play brings up 3rd down.
And the Seahawks on 3rd down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This will be 3rd and 6. Throwing is Wilson. And he's got his target. That's Moore. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. From 17 yards out. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further.
An excellent, long, sustained offensive drive. And now they can look across the field and see a defense that looks a little bit beaten down. Right now, as an offensive coordinator, you're thinking to yourself, can I dial up the knockout punch?
The extra point now coming from Myers. It's good to make it 17-7.
Makes the score Seahawks 17.
A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And the Seahawks capping it off with a touchdown. For the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The offense and Alvin Kamara heading back onto the field. And for him, it's been pretty limited involvement. Down on the scoreboard, maybe time to turn to this guy.
And you know me well. Winning games to me means starting with the running game and continuing to press the running game. Maybe you go away from him a little bit now, but the bottom line is he hasn't touched it enough to make a difference.
Well, they haven't established that running game yet. The question is, will they? Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It'll be a Saints first down on a gain of 16 yards. So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line. Play action. Breeze. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A well-executed 22-yard gain. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. It'll be a Saints first down on a pickup of 13.
I'm not sure you can be more efficient on offense than to have three downs and have them all turn into first downs. And defensively, you've got to figure out how to slow them down. Some guys might bring more pressure. Some guys might be a little more exotic. And as a last resort, you might even call timeout and try and regroup. I got you
pumped. Staying on the ground on first with Kamara. And he'll get it down inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It's a loss of two, now third down. The Saints on third down. They've hit two for four thus far. This will be third and five. Throwing now is Breeze. And that's caught by Smith. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Great mix of play calling so far. Three runs, three passes. All three passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll try to run it in with Murray. And he'll barrel his way into the end zone for a Saint touchdown. Taking it in from a yard out, as they are now just an extra point away from making this a three-point game.
We got a little bit of everything on that run. Offensive line creating some space, but how about the guy running behind his pads into the end zone?
What does that mean when a guy says running behind his pad? It
means that he's going to be a physical runner. That way he's able to use his shoulder pads, his forearms, anything to ward off people to power his way forward.
Lutz to try to add the PAT. And this is up and good to make it a 17-14 game. So that drives seven plays in length. And it culminates with a Latavius Murray touchdown run. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Chris Carson trotting back out there. He's in his own second quarter, already closing in on a 100-yard game.
And that's the magic number for a running back. Anytime you get to that triple digits, that's all you're looking for. But he's got a chance to really exceed that in this one.
Yeah, he does. That's been the gold standard for a long time, hasn't it, that 100-yard mark?
It really has, and that never has to shift because it's in a game. It's a 1,000-yard mark. I'm wondering, since we've gone from 12 to 14 to 16 games, maybe we need to up that a little.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. On the delay, here's Carson. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 7 yards there and a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now they'll run on the draw. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. Second and 9. Wilson, this complete to Lockett. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 41-yard line. So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 41. Here's Wilson. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. Wilson now to throw again. Now they go screen. It's complete. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
The Seahawks on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is third and 9. To throw again is Wilson. Wide open receiver complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 23. Wilson now, 12 of 15, throwing the ball, 80% so far, and it's first and 10. They'll run on first down. Carson. Tackle is made by Cameron Jordan. On second and 9, Wilson. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down.
Quarterbacking 101. Never force the ball into double coverage, especially not this close to the goal line. The windows are so tight, you just don't want to force it in there because it could be tipped up and picked off.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. Dancing to his left. He can run for it, and he will. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now fourth down.
Well, he was looking at a dime formation, six defensive backs on the field, so he's looking for anyone to throw the football to, but he didn't have anyone open, so he took off and ran for it, but he came up just short, and that brings up fourth down.
And Myers able to knock it through, and they stretch the lead to six. It's 20-14 now. So unable to convert for the touchdown inside the red zone, but they do come away with three.
Yeah, it's a 32-yarder. That's essentially an extra point nowadays, right? Because it's 33 as a general rule for these guys. So it should be a simple kick. But you know what's really strange nowadays? When they miss an extra point, I think they carry that with them longer than missing a field goal, because an extra point's supposed to be automatic.
Absolutely, and I would think even field goals inside of 30 yards, even though they're substantially shorter than a PAT, it just has a different feel, doesn't it?
A different feel, a different vibe. That's what I get from all the kickers I talk to. They always say, if I miss an extra point, that's the one that bothers me more.
Myers now converted on the field goal try. Now he's on to kick it away. This is taken at the three. He's going to be stopped here with a penalty marker on the field.
Personal foul.
I'm not sure what this is about.
Defense.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
So the face mask gets him a free 15 to start the drive. On the counter, here's Kamara. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Ready? 95-56.
On second down, Kamara. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Call it a loss of two on the play. And that'll bring up a third down.
No surprise there, Jadeveon Clowney with a tackle for loss. We all know how he became one of the most famous players in football, though, don't we remember?
Oh, that one play.
Yeah, that one big-time play was on highlights everywhere. They want to see more of that here in the NFL.
The Saints on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This is third and eight. Breeze now to throw. This is complete to Michael Thomas. He'll get 15 and a Saints first down. Breeze now 11 of 16 through the air. It's first and 10. Breeze now. And that's incomplete. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Here's Breeze to throw. Complete. Smith has it. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
It's a gain of four. Brings up third and six.
The Saints on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. This will be third and six. To throw, it's Breeze. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. They send Thomas out to the right by himself.
Go.
Breeze to throw again. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. They'll go again from the 3 here on 2nd and goal.
Here we go, here we go.
Now they'll run, Murray. And he will make his way back to where he started from, and that's all, as we will make our way to the 2-minute warning. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Reminder coming up here at halftime. We'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. Now throwing on 3rd down there, but he cannot connect. So they opted to pass for it on 3rd and goal. Let's see what they do on 4th and goal.
Well, I think they threw it with the idea that if they didn't get it, they would go for it on 4th and goal. So they've got another play in their pocket. They're going to have to call it right now. No field goal here.
On 4th down, off goes Drew Brees, and on comes the Saints kicker, Will Lutz, for the field goal attempt. This is less than an extra point, just a 19-yard attempt. So it's an old-school extra point that counts 3 times. It's certainly a disappointment they weren't able to get it in the end zone.
Yeah, I can just imagine post-game, head coach looking at the box score, 19-yard field goal, grimacing a little bit, but having to realize that at that moment, getting 3 points was vital. Go ahead and get the points, put them on the board.
Following the made field goal, Lutz to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. He'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Marshawn Lynch heading back out into the huddle. We're in the 2nd quarter. They've got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what they're seeing so far is the possibility of things loosening up later in the ground game. Through the air first, maybe they have to start respecting that even more as the game goes on, and then there will be running lanes.
Pressure comes, and Wilson's gonna go down. Cameron Jordan able to drop him that time for his 2nd sack of the evening. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is 2nd and long. And he'll give it here to his running back. And that closed up quickly there as he gets it up only to about the 17. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
Man, I got you.
On third down, it's Carson. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Now here's Michael Dixon as he'll kick it away for the second time. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. Michael Thomas now heading back onto the field. And he's been pretty good under the lights here tonight, hasn't he, partner?
He certainly has, and I applaud him for that because I don't know what it's like for you, but to me, preparing for a night game involves a little bit more. Trying to hold your intensity, hold that edge throughout an entire day of waiting to get out there and play. You know, the meetings, what time you're going to eat, all of those things. He's harnessed it very well. It's turning in a nice performance.
Yeah, he's closing in on 100 yards. For me, it's all about the afternoon nap for a night game.
I like the way you prep.
The Saints in the hurry up here. Clock continuing to roll. To throw again on second down. Breeze. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there. Trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Basically, you're not going to outwork two guys very often.
Double coverage. I thought he was going to go somewhere else for the football. I get it. That's a stud wide receiver. You want to try to get him the football.
Yeah, sometimes you rely on him a bit too much. You forget the other options that are out there.
Now Breeze on third down. Open man is Michael Thomas. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout, as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Breeze now closing in on a 200-yard first half through the air. It's first and 10. Again, it's Breeze. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. So a challenge coming down from the booth, and that's where these challenges come from, of course, in the final 2 minutes of the half.
Yeah, now we're going to New York, right? That's command central for the officials. They'll talk, they'll take a look at it, communicate with the referee at the game site, and issue a final decision because they do have the final call now. This challenge was initiated by the guys in New York taking a look at the play. Less than 2 minutes to go.
Yeah, I'm sure the coach wanted to challenge it, so he's probably going to send the New York office a holiday card. The distance was never the question there, but he gets a friendly bounce to carom that thing through the uprights.
Yeah, and when you're trying to hit from 50-plus, you got to expect the ball's going to slide one way or the other. So he's pretty fortunate there that he's able to bank this one in.
Fitting for what's been a tight ball game. We're all even at 20 now as the kick's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10.
And they're just going to run it here up the middle.
And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags.
Defense.
Charles, I know it's hard when live bullets are flying, but you cannot keep your hand up around the face mask area.
It is absolutely inexcusable nowadays. We talk about target areas all the time. You have to aim lower so that your hand doesn't get involved in the face mask.
Now it's first and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. He's going to look deep for more, and he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. So thanks to the late field goal, we are all tied up heading to intermission. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report.
We thought this one would be a close battle coming in, and we have not been disappointed. But they are all even to this point. So to see if either side can pull away, let's get you right back out to Brandon and Charles for the start of the second half.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now we'll see what Michael Thomas and the rest of the offense has in store here. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it? Right. Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. Second and six, no, lady, just no, inside the 30.
Get ready.
Running with Kamara. He'll have a first down past the 40 and all the way up to the 45-yard line. It'll be a Saints first down on a gain of 16 yards. Those are the type of runs that we did not see from him in the first half, but a good start to the third quarter.
And I know what everyone's thinking that's watching this. They did a great job adjusting at the half. Oftentimes, you don't make adjustments. You just dial into your game plan a little bit better, and maybe they're starting to make some headway.
So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10. Now Breeze. And brought in by the tight end Cook. Now he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. That one goes for 24 yards.
Oh boy, when a good tight end reads man coverage, is able to run the corner route, almost impossible to defend. They can use the good head fake, work him inside, and then they'll get him on their back or on their hip and keep them away from the football with their body.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10, down at the 31. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And Kamara has it stripped, and the Seahawks have picked it up. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. And he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. So many times tight games decided by one big play. A lot of times, of course, it's the offense. Here, it's the defense coming up huge.
And you know head coaches walk around locker rooms, walk around bench areas saying, guys, somebody make a play. It's a cliche, but it applies here.
Now Myers for the extra point. Oh, this is blocked. It's picked up. A live ball here, remember. Look at the big man rumble. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. Past the 20. And he takes it the distance across the goal line for 2 points.
All I know, partners, that with every play call that came in, there was a little discussion about, hey, we can seal this bad boy. We can really put ourselves in a great spot to take total control. And yet, they find a way to cough it up.
Yeah, the two-score game opportunity eludes them, and now a chance for the other side to come back here.
Yeah, that means defense has to go out there and make some plays themselves. So we call sudden change. Let's see if the defense is mentally ready to take care of it.
So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This fielded at the 2. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Alvin Kamara and the Saints set to start their next drive. Looking for a bounce back. Had the fumble a moment ago that went for a touchdown the other direction. See if he can get back in rhythm.
And you have to be very careful about having too quick of a hook with really good players. I did a guy's game in high school where he fumbled 3 times in the first quarter, finished with over 300 yards on the night, later ended up in the NFL. If you got a talented back, give it back to him.
Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. 14 yards is the pickup, first down New Orleans.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. A 10th carry for Kamara. And some room to maneuver. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 14 yards is the pickup. First down, New Orleans.
Now that's how you start to get back in the good graces of your head coach. Remember, he fumbled on the last possession. How about the faith they showed him, giving him the ball again, and he repaid them, picking up a first down.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. And this is Cook with a grab. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. A gain of 6 there on first. Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. To throw is Breeze. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Trey Flowers picks it, and this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas.
Ah, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. The drive starts with C.J. Procise. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That one good for 14 and a Seahawk first.
Partner, we always talk about how important third down is, but I think first down is equally important because everything comes off of that play. If the defense wins the down, they are able to attack. If the offense wins the down, they might go faster, do other things, and change things up. That big play right there allows this offense to really get in gear.
On first down, Carson. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9. 1 yard gain. Brings up 2nd and 9. At the 47-yard line.
What? Move the team! 47. Check, check, 47. Watch the backer, watch the backer.
On 2nd and 9. Wilson. And his throw here is incomplete.
Wilson's pass intended for DK Metcalf. Incomplete.
They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. From the gun, it's Wilson. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. Cameron Jordan bringing the pressure yet again. That's his third sack here tonight. Now here's Michael Dixon as he's on to punt for Seattle. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive,
nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The sack there by Rasheem Green. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
Now, following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Now, Breeze. Ginn has it complete. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
That's a gain of 8. Brings up third and 9.
And the Seahawks add a couple of extra DBs going with the dime look here.
Indeed, 6 on the field. From the gun, it's Breeze. The open man is Smith. Now he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. 23 yards, the final tally. Now, perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's 1st and 10. Shotgun now for Breeze. This is caught by Ginn. Now, a loose football. The ball comes out, and the Seahawks have picked it up. And he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Russell Wilson now gears up to lead the offense again. He's been a good game manager. They're winning here in the third quarter, but really the ground game is where it's been at for them, hasn't it?
So whatever the game plan was, you just got to focus on continuing to run the football. And really, that takes the pressure off of the guy throwing it around. Doesn't have to be the focal point. Hand it off. Let him chew up the yardage and big plays. And your team's winning. The only people upset, the fantasy guys who may have started him at quarterback in their leagues.
And we'll see if they continue with the recipe of the ground game. They'll try to get the offense going with Kamara. And he loses the football a second time. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. First down and 10. And Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and give these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards. From midfield now, here's Wilson. He'll find Metcalf, and they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 11 yards there and a first down for Seattle. First down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. This one into the hands of Metcalf. First down, Seattle, 16 yards the gain there. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Wilson after the play fake to Carson. They'll roll him out right. And now he's going to use his legs. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
A gain of five brings up second and five at the Saints' 18-yard line.
Let's get ready for three.
Check, check. Watch 54. Watch 54.
Come to my work.
You ain't good.
Come to my
work. On second down now, it's Carson. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Chris Carson, his second touchdown of the night. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. Nice execution there. Good job by the O-line getting him in for the second time.
And you always have to start with credit there when you're having a big game. I mean, you don't get there by yourself. That's rare. But how about the ability to see the proper holes, pick the proper place to go, and find his way into the end zone.
The extra point now coming from Myers. And that one pushes the lead up to 11. So that drive spanned five plays, and it was all capped off by the Chris Carson touchdown run. After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, That's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
At the 26-yard line.
Ready. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26. There's Breeze. That'll be complete to Cook. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
In today's NFL, we're accustomed to the tight end getting downfield and creating plays and wreaking a little havoc in the secondary. Not on this one, though. They diagnosed that one really well.
Tried the dump off, lost yardage. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Breeze gonna throw. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. Now nearing the 300-yard mark with still a corner to play. It's first and 10. This one into the hands of Ginn out wide. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. They'll run. This is Kamara. And oh my goodness, he loses it again.
I'm gonna hit you all day, baby.
And they'll need the 39 here for a first. This is third down. Breeze now to throw. And Ginn's got it. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. And they just keep marching right along. First down on a pickup of 8 there. Breeze going to come up here, first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Breeze, a quick throw out to Thomas. No gain there on the completion, second and 10. To the ground. It's Kamara.
Get there.
5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
Can we just take that run and turn it into a kind of a clip and save? Because that tells you everything you need to know about this drive. They've been moving the ball awfully well.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now Breeze. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. What a methodical drive this is turning out to be. That time 9 yards, and the sticks move again. This quarterback now over 300 yards now for the game, and time to improve on that as he's got a first and 10. They run with Murray. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. They stay on the ground. This time it's Kamara. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line.
Let's go, let's go,
9
go.
Yards the pick up there, and it's a first down. Incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. The busy night continues for Kamara. And Kamara has it stripped. And defensively going with a dime set. 6 DBs on 3rd and 4. Throwing now is Breeze. And they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. Jaron Reed in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to 4th down. So now the field goal unit trots out there for the 3rd time tonight.
A 32-yard attempt. That's the end of the 3rd quarter of play with the score of Seahawks 33, Saints 22.
3 quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And Lutz puts this one through. And that'll make this an 8-point game. So good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coaches always talk about finishing a drive with a kick. 2 of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
Field goal, Lutz to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Chris Carson trotting back out there. He's already hit pay dirt twice. He's up over 100 yards. He is feeling good.
And he's just zipping along today. everything coming together for him. It's that type of a day that you see a back just kind of have a grin on his face every time his number is called, because he doesn't feel like there are going to be any lost yardage plays. Nothing but big-time positive runs.
Making the sideline grin as well. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Well, from my vantage point, that's just one bad play by the offensive line and a running back who's had a lot of good ones tonight.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean he's not going to be ticked off, nor is the offensive line, because to me it's a lot like a no-hitter, right? Pitcher's throwing a no-hitter, gives up a hit late. You're so close to accomplishing everything you want and don't quite get it done. They'll come back with a vengeance on the next play.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They run again with Carson. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
Now, that's a nice play. Got me fired up, partner. But can they do it back-to-back plays? All the training that you go through as a defense for these situations, when you have to get the ball back, everything you go through, holding up the runner, raking at the football, getting to the passer, knocking it out of his hands, whatever way, they have to get the ball back.
Now can they stand tall again for a huge fourth quarter stop? So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. From the shotgun, Wilson shedding through the defense. He's got Lockett. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. Wilson now, five straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. He hits his running back, Crosize. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Pass play wound up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11. Now a handoff here to his running back. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there. And he nearly got the first himself, but it appears he's going to be about a yard or two short. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now fourth down. Now here's Michael Dixon. He's been terrific so far. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. Out of out is the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you gotta like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game.
A breakaway for Michael Thomas, 30. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. A big play, Breeze finding Thomas, and even 80 yards. Prime example there of how his height can be an advantage. It makes it tough on some of these smaller defensive backs.
When they try and go through that type of a receiver to get the football, oftentimes that big body, that frame will block them away. And whether the receiver has to elevate or extend, now he has a clear path to the football with the defender usually on his back.
First and goal, a touchdown and a two-point conversion here are musts.
I can't believe they even let you play.
Here's Breeze to throw. And that is incomplete here. Looking to go back to Thomas again, but it'll be second and goal. Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. On the ground, Kamara. And he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Breeze now on third and goal. And this is Cook with a grab. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. A great job to hold him to just a yard there. Now it's fourth and goal.
Well, partner, they're still going to have to go for it after that play. And I'm not sure that the running game is going to be a part of what they have to do on fourth down now.
From this far out, you wouldn't think so. Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. To throw, it's Breeze. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Ted Ginn there to make the grab as they now sit just a 2-point conversion away from tying this game up in the fourth quarter.
Fourth and goal, and they found a way to throw it in the end zone for a touchdown.
And these defenses, they just like three downs, get off the field. But here they had to go 4, couldn't get it done.
A lot of the time, you're looking up and saying, okay, if I hold them for 3, at worst, I give up a field goal attempt. When they go for it, sometimes it really affects the defense because maybe they're not mentally prepared to go that fourth down.
To throw is Breeze. And he's got it. The conversion good, and we are tied in the 4th. Still time to work with on the clock, but they wanted the tie now, and they got it.
And I love their aggressiveness. Go ahead and get it done. Get the game tied. Now your team has the momentum, and you're staring across the field saying, let's see if you can match us.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
What? Who it is?
Check line 54. Line 54. Target.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Carson. Only gets 3 yards there on the heels of the one-yard pickup. Sets up third and six. To throw on third down, Wilson. That's complete to Disley, the tight end. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 11 yards there and a first down for Seattle. Wilson now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. To throw is Wilson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Cameron Jordan, make that now 4 sacks for him in tonight's ball game. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Now it's Wilson. Quick slant, caught by Moore. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
A gain of 7 yards. And it's third down.
On third down, Wilson. Yeah, quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. It's a gain of 15, first down Seahawks. So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. From the gun, it's Wilson. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Give the sack to David Onyemata, the product of Nigeria by way of Canada. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Here's Wilson. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Wilson from the gun, he'll throw. And this is going to be incomplete. Now here's Michael Dixon as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Now Breeze, and brought in by the tight end Cook. And he'll be upended after a gain of five, up to the 25-yard line. Here's a second and five now from the 25. Breeze on the draw, gives to Kamara. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. He lost two there, and it's third down.
A draw play is called because you think you've either found a gap or you're using the aggressiveness of the defensive line against itself. Not on that play. Totally controlled the middle of the field. Offense had nowhere to go with the ball.
It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. Shotgun now for Breeze. It's caught, Smith. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 17 there and a New Orleans first down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works a defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
Ready. 95, 56.
50, Mike, 50.
Hey, man. Watch the boot.
They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. His carries tonight, they're getting up there, so maybe one of those every now and then is understandable.
I would agree with that. Understandable every now and then. Sometimes you come back and you fake it to him and go play action. But other times you say, okay, they got him on that one. We'll come back to him in another carry.
Throwing on second down, Breeze. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 34-yard line.
Okay, when the big guy runs a corner route, you're asking a lot no matter who's covering him, no matter whether it's a linebacker or a defensive back. He usually has the advantage because of his body type.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 34. Breeze now. Incomplete. From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10.
All right, D, left side. All right, D. Shift! Watch the shift!
On the ground, this is Kamara. He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. 25 yards, the pickup there, and also a first down.
Here we go.
Hey, we haven't been around the entire time football's been played, but we have studied our history, and there have been some great backs who've been accused of running out of bounds to protect themselves. Well, back in the day, many people didn't like that. But nowadays, take care of the football, show some intelligence, live to fight another down.
A field goal could get him the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal. They keep it on the ground, but this time it's Murray. He pushes forward for maybe three down to the 6-yard line. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. They'll try the counter with Washington. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go as a 1-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Now Breeze. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Okay, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? The leg's still there. This has been a tough game. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This for the lead in the final stages. And Lutz's kick is good. And with that, they will move out in front by three. So good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coaches always talk about finishing a drive with a kick. Two of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
To kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So Wilson and the Seahawks down by a field goal. 2 minutes, 17 seconds to go. Plenty of time here. They've got three timeouts and the 2-minute warning as they've got it first and 10. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now left side on the swing pass. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. Now this one complete downfield on the left side. The 30, 10, and all the way in. Touchdown, Seattle. DK Metcalf, 77 yards. And the Seahawks are going to retake the lead.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation, But to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game. That drive started on their own 25. Two plays, 75 yards later, into the end zone. Touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This fielded at the two. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The offense and Alvin Kamara heading back onto the field. And in the early going, the running game, as we see the numbers, it just wasn't on point. Well, now it's gotten more true to form.
And sometimes it takes a little while for an offensive line to get in sync. Because early in the game, defenses throw different patterns at you, different formations, different sets. And you might not block them quite the way you want to. But as you start to get into a groove and you figure out what they're doing, now it all comes together, and that's what we're seeing right now.
And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22.
Now you're right on the edge of field goal range. You've still got time, but get up to the line of scrimmage and get set.
First down now, but that clock rolling.
Hey, watch that, watch that.
Back to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Jaron Reed in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. It felt like he was in the pocket all day, never got rid of it.
And when you have that much time, you've got to either find someone open or get rid of it, because with that amount of time to throw the ball, that means the offensive line's done a really nice job.
They'll look to throw, and his throw is incomplete.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command it, make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze. Able to find Harris. Complete. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 29-yard line.
I'm a little surprised right here. They've got three timeouts left. The clock's running down, and they aren't using them. Those timeouts do you no good at home. Use them now.
It's incomplete.
The out route's such a timing route that sometimes the guy throwing the ball just throws it almost blindly, just kind of counts on that timing winning. And in this case, the ball was batted away.
Ready. Here's second and 10 now from the 29.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Here we go again.
He's back to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Jaron Reed in there to drop him as that clock continues to run. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ballgame. Third and long now after the sack of Breeze, and the Saints up against it here. He'll look to throw. And that's caught by Smith. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. Exciting to the very end. That's what we just saw in this game. Final play there, had it in the red zone, but anytime you're outside of the 10, that's tough trying to draw up a final play to get in, and they couldn't do it.
It certainly is. So what they were looking for was, you know, extra time. Too bad it's not FIFA soccer, right, where you get a little bit of extra and you get a chance to run a couple more plays and maybe get closer and take that last shot into the end zone.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. From New Orleans, good night, everybody.